All right, let's start off with our first big story. The Nigerian Senate has rejected the list of 46 ambassadorial nominees sent to it for screening and confirmation because of protests over the unequal representation and petitions by state governors and pressure groups.
But the Senate confirmed the first list of 47 career ambassadors sent to it. TVC News' Somna Sambo reports.
The presidency has again been hit below the belt by the Senate. This time, senators have refused to approve its list of political nominees for ambassadorial positions, despite recent meetings to tighten loose ends by both arms of government. At Tuesday's plenary, the Senate rejected the request, while at the same time confirming the earlier list of 47 career ambassadors. The Committee on Foreign Affairs, while submitting its report on the screening, had asked the Senate to return the troubled second list due to over 250 petitions received against nominees.
But unfortunately, the 46 that we have is even having more problems than the 47. I mean, so far now we have received over 250 petitions on the last, the non-careers. We are finding it difficult to start our screening. But my suggestion and my proposal to Senate is for us to return this 46 back to the executives.
On the list of the non-career ambassadors submitted, the committee recommended that this Senate do return the list to Mr. President for submission. That shall be the motion of the Senate. I so move.
The list of non-career ambassadors should be sent to Mr. President for resubmission in view of the series of petitions that we have received. Those in favor of that say aye. Those against say nay. The ayes have it. The nomination of Iyang Doyang is hereby confirmed as career ambassador of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. We hope that they will be good ambassadors for this great country, represent us properly, and also show the confidence that has been given by the Senate in confirming their nominations.
State governors of the ruling APC had earlier protested their non-involvement in the selection of the non-career ambassadorial nominees by President Muhammadu Buhari, while some nominees cited failure to consult them as the reason they rejected positions that they were offered. Somna Sambu, TVC News, Abuja.
Well, they have indeed returned, you know, this list of non-career diplomats back to the president for rejigging and resubmission.
Yeah, resubmission.
Oh, well.
Well, we look forward to a way where all the reasons why they were rejected would have been settled before it is represented to the Senate.
So it's not a blow below the belt again, like Somna Sambo says in that report. Well, we have joining us a public affairs analyst, Olukayo Desalako. He's also the national coordinator, Change Agents of Nigeria Network. Thanks for joining us on the show this morning.
Yeah, good morning.
Well, that report, was very, very comprehensive, telling us about why the Senate returned this list of non-career ambassadors back to the president for rejigging and all of that. But to you, what is wrong or not with this particular list? I'm sure you've been able to look at the list and make up your mind about, the names on it.
Well, in my own opinion, I think what has been the problem with this present government is the fact that it wants to be operating independently of the party platform interests. I think Mr. President would have to think of carrying the interests of his party along in some of the things he does in this government, because he emerged through a partisan party platform. And if you are a president, from a partisan party platform, and you cannot, you cannot say you want to be operating, you know, independently. That party platform, the interest must be carried along. After all, when you were contesting on that platform, you were consulting, you were carrying other, you know, important stakeholders along. So now that you have become the president, you don't now say because you belong to everybody. Now, you now want to be appointing people to work with you from the list of that everybody. You, as Mr. President, I've always said it, cannot belong to everybody.
Okay.
All right.
All right.
Let's come back to this.
Yes.
The government of everybody.
Yes. Okay. We'll come back to this. Let's go on a break shortly, and then we come back to dwell more on this topic. Stay with us. All right. If you're just joining us, you're watching TVC Breakfast. On this segment, we are discussing the 46 ambassadorial nominees that were returned from the Senate to the presidency on the grounds of petition and maybe lack of consultation, as some quarters had put it. But we have with us in the studio Olukayode Salako. He is the National Coordinator of Change Agent Nigeria Network. We've been talking about this. Now, Kayode, let me ask this. This is not the first document that's been returned from the Senate back to the presidency.
Definitely.
Now, how does that tell about the executive and legislative relation generally?
Well, I think this present executive only wants to run Nigeria and should also learn to play the politics. This is a democratic system. It's a democratic governance. So if you only want to run the governance, you only want to run the country, and you don't want to play the politics the way it's supposed to be played, then that is when you will start facing this type of problems. Under normal circumstances, the relationship between the executive and the legislature is supposed to be robust and very good. Once that cannot be first of all achieved, that is when you start experiencing this type of document submission and document, you know, returns and all of that. So, I want to advise Mr. President and the people handling his relationship with the legislature to look into how they can buy into the interest of the leadership of the Senate and the National Assembly. Once there is a cordial relationship between the two of them, some of these things that come to the public, the executive will submit a document, and publicly the National Assembly will come and return it, wouldn't have been necessary. That should have been a kind of backdoor arrangement where Mr. President should have been able to inform the leadership of the National Assembly.
You've used a number of expressions that I'm really, really curious about.
Yes.
You know, backdoor arrangement, carrying people along, you know, how the politics should be played and
yes.
all of that.
Yes.
Exactly what do you mean? When we say, you know, you're not carrying your party members along and you're not, you know, factoring in their interest, what exactly are we talking about?
Well,
should we be looking at the interests of a few people or the party or the overall interest of Nigeria and Nigerians?
All over the world.
Yes.
In democracy, the executive, the party in power must also have substantial control of the legislature. You know, the senators, the National Assembly members, they must be in control because it is the party that is in power. And where the Senate and the National Assembly are not in control, the party in power is not in control of the Senate and the National Assembly, it will always be a problem. The executive cannot run have a smooth running government.
Yeah, but
so
in this case, the political party that owns the government, that is the executive, is the majority in the Senate, is the majority in the House of Reps.
I don't believe so. I don't believe this present National Assembly, the present party in power is the one in control of the President National Assembly. I don't believe so.
Why not?
If it is so, then some of this beckoning, some of these document submission, document, you know, returns and all of that would have been better managed.
Are they not doing the job of checks and balances? Isn't that what they should be doing?
Yes. The National Assembly must play its role. And it is their role, it seems, they're playing. But this role should have been better played if there had been better relationship between the executive and the legislature. What the present government must seek to achieve first is that relationship. Once there is that relationship, that necessary relationship, then some of the things that come to the public, it's not everything that, you know, that is supposed to be coming to the public. Some of these things would have been done. The president would have been able to let the leadership of the National Assembly know that, oh, this is what I want to do. This is what I want to submit next. I want you to have an idea of it. It should have been properly advised. There should have been a kind of pre-meeting before, and they would have been able to tell him, Oga, this is how we want you to do it.
That's a way of lobbying, eh?
It might not necessarily mean about that, you know, peculiar what lobbying means in this country, in this climate. So, if there is a relationship, what I'm saying is there should have been a kind of pre-talks, discussions, negotiations before that document will not be finally submitted. By the time the document is not submitted, it is only little things the National Assembly would have to complain about.
But so you do understand, of course, we appreciate what you're trying to say here, but you do understand there's a Yoruba adage, I think in other parts of the country too, you know, that when two people go into a room, a closed door meeting, and they come back, they come out smiling, you know they've told each other lies.
Yes.
But when they come out, you know, frowning, you know that, look, they've laid it out on the table, the facts are there. What kind of rapport, you know, do you think that the executive and the legislature should be having in such a way that it is not at the expense of Nigerians?
It is that type of rapport that can always impact positively on the socio-economic, you know, survival of an average Nigerian. This is 2 years into the government, and yet so many leaves keep going in and coming back. Which suggests to me that the executive, this present executive, and the legislature are still not on the same page. If it is true that it is the party in power that also has the majority in the National Assembly. If it is so, what is going to cause Mr. President to inform the leadership of the Senate of his intention? Oh, by next week, I'm going to be submitting the list. And you should let them have the idea of how those people were selected, blah, blah, blah. And if there is any reason for them to say, okay, Mr. President, this is our own advice for you before the list gets worse. Go and work on this. So, Mr. President, and his people would have had an idea of
what to expect.
To expect from the Senate before the list would have been submitted, so that there could be a kind of speedy passage.
Yes. Yeah,
so all these things are impacting negatively on the socio-economic lot.
All right, let's see from the other window, because I remember the Senate president at the time was saying when the names of ministerial lists were submitted at first, he said that we're going to do a thorough job. Now, in this light, we also see that if we have to beam it to the ambassadorial list, we want to say that the Senate is trying to do a thorough job in that context.
Yes.
Now, if there is this party thing, and let's pass it because it's our political party, wouldn't it undermine the objectivity or the thoroughness, let me say, the thoroughness of screening these people?
This is not even about the Senate this time around. It's about complaints from some quarters.
From the members of the public, as we were told.
From the party in power, some of the major stakeholders, the APC governors, are also protesting. That they are not comfortable with the personalities on those lists.
Are they really complaining about the personalities, or that, you know, the fact that they were not carried along you know, like you said, the non-inclusion.
It is still about the personalities.
The governors were not carried, especially the APC governors.
If I say you didn't carry me along with your affairs, and I now submit a list to you, definitely you won't be comfortable with whatever I submit to you. So what they are saying is,
they don't have an idea
of those personalities on those lists. They didn't know anything about it. And all of these things are not supposed to be happening like that. Even the Senate has come out now to say about 250 petitions have been received. From who?
Members of the public.
Who are those members of the public? From PDP?
Some of them governors.
Or from the opposition parties? Definitely some of these petitions might have been submitted by people who feel our party platform has not been carried along.
Okay, let's even end that particular line of discussion about whether they've been carried along or not. Let's look at some of the names. Pauline Tallon, of course, she had rejected, you know, her nomination on this non-career, you know, list. Let's not lose sight of that, because the other list of career diplomats, of course, was approved. 47 or so of them. You had Bugaje too, who rejected his own nomination.
All right.
The reason they're giving, of course, you know, they were not consulted. Pauline Tallon, for example, she had, you know, personal issues to attend to, and that's why she found herself not able to, you know, take up or accept this nomination. And then there's the issue of Bayelsa State, Imo, and some of, you know, FCT that were not included, both in the first list and this non-career list.
That's so what should we make of it? That there was no enough thorough consultation. If there had been proper consultation, some of these complaints would have been taken care of even before the list was submitted to the public. The Senate, the National Assembly, is our public house. So I believe that if you want to appoint me,
yes,
to work for you, I must have been pre-informed. I must have had an idea about it. And I must have been able to tell you whether I am interested in accepting the job or not. So for my name to now appear on the list, and for me to now say, oh, I am rejecting the offer, simply shows that consultations were not properly done. But at the same time, we have to realize that Mr. President has a right, the constitutional right, to choose whoever he feels is okay to work with him. That is his prerogative right. But at the same time, he emerged through a partisan platform. And that platform must also continue to be carried along. If he still needs that platform,
okay,
after these 4 years,
it's all right. We'll come back to to talk about more on this consultation that you have hammered on. We'll go on a break now, but don't forget that we'll be going out on TVC Entertainment, and viewers there can continue with the program on TVC Nigeria on Concert Channel 190 and DSTV Channel 418.
Also, Go TV 45 and ACTV 510. There's more to talk about on this ambassadorial list. Stay with us.
All right, if you're just joining us, you're watching TVC Breakfast. On this segment, we are discussing the 46 ambassadorial nominee list that was returned from the Senate to the presidency.
The non-career, exactly.
46 yes. Non-career ambassadorial nominees. We have in the studio the national coordinator of the Change Agent Nigeria Network, Olukayode Salako. We've been talking about this. Now, Kayode, when we talk about consultation, It's a very strong word that resonates in politics generally. Consultation
right.
with people.
Right.
Now, in this case, if consultation will have to be made on the ideal ground, what kind of consultation should the president have made before this? Give us a picture of who and who are the people, what are the institutions he's supposed to consult?
During the election period, all the progressives, the major stakeholders, they were united. They were very, very united during the election. They should also be united now they're in power. Now that they're in power, they should also be united in order to be able to deliver to us that new Nigeria they promised us.
So, if during the elections, they were consulting perfectly, they were getting it right in terms of consultation. Consultation means carrying the stakeholders along, letting them know what the next program is on the agenda. There is an agenda. Mr. President came to come and implement for Nigeria. And
the change inside, agenda?
Yeah, the change agenda, which I have also bought into. I'm also a stakeholder too in my own right. So, inside this agenda, there are programs to be implemented. And there is no way Mr. President cannot get to power and wants to be implementing these programs independently of the same platform that brought him to power. So, it is not everything he has to go and tell his party. There are certain things that are his rights. But I feel within that right, he should also make his party interest to feel important. Because this is, politics must have to be played. Politics was played before he became the president, and he must also continue to play that politics to be able to run his government smoothly.
But that is if we're able to define exactly what politics we're talking about. I mean, the conventional definition of politics, the equitable distribution
consulting
of wealth, right,
who gets what, how, and when.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But the issue there is, I want to be able to narrow it down, because for the sake of people who are viewers who are listening, yes, who are watching, I like them to also know, when a list is being sent, for this kind of list, for instance, yes, you want to send it to the National Assembly, and now people are complaining we were not consulted. Now, who are the people that should be consulted to have a smooth run? That's what we're saying.
Well, thank you very much.
Especially as it pertains to this ambassadorial list.
In as much as Mr. President must always continue to look for the round peg, the round hole, the right people, we obviously need career diplomats. People who know about the job, they know what they're going to do wherever they're being posted to. People who can represent Nigeria well, people who know their onions. In as much as that, I also believe that some of these career diplomats, many of them would have been progressives who are probably inside that party platform that brought Mr. President out. Some of those people could be invited, interviewed. They should also be, I don't want to use the word compensated, for working for their parties.
But even if you were to use that word, they have already been compensated. The career diplomats list has been approved by the Senate. The real issue here now is the non-career diplomats.
The non-career diplomats, yes. It has always been our tradition in Nigeria to appoint anybody to go and represent Nigeria. I would have preferred that everybody on that list should be a professional career diplomat. But for some of them, being members of the same platform, the political platform that Mr. President is governing on, and by the time that opportunity is exhausted, maybe okay, after looking into APC, there are no career diplomats there anymore, no qualified people, then you cannot go outside of that, but you still have to carry, especially the governors of your party platform along. Because that's what we call, that's this principle of federal character in our constitution. Federal character means you cannot just continue to be appointing people from one state. You have to spread the opportunities. So in that process, there are governors, APC governors, from the party platform upon which the president is governing. Get them involved. Inform them. I need a very good career diplomat in Abia State. Possibly from our party platform interest. But if there is none, set up a committee, consult your people, and let them give me somebody that can go and represent Nigeria that everybody will be happy with.
But can we really do that realistically when we still play politics of winner takes all?
And that is why politics should not be about everything we do in Nigeria. Politics should not be about everything. There is too much of politics in everything we do. And that is why our country is still where it is. We have to learn to start seeking for bona fide Nigerians, Nigerians who are not criminals, credible Nigerians, Nigerians of integrity, Nigerians who deserve to serve their fatherland, who are very good. We can start getting them involved. But at the same time, you cannot neglect your party platform.
All right,
because politics is very important in democracy.
Okay, let's see. All right, let's see it this way. Many, in fact, all the states are broken into three senatorial zones.
You are right.
That's the case, maybe. Now, some of the states do this rotational governorship where the governor comes from here, this tenure, and then the next senatorial district is supposed to produce the next governor and all of that. They base their politics on that. And then they try to see how they can balance appointments also. If the governor is coming from this senatorial district,
from North Central,
exactly,
for example,
from this senatorial district, then the ambassador should come from here and then the minister should come from here as a way of balancing. Does that complicate the way appointments are made when you talk about consultation with the people back home so that this kind of rotation is balanced?
Well, if the principle of federal character must be satisfied, must be carried along in this premise, then I think that is necessary. But by carrying the major stakeholders along, you see, politics is all about consultations and negotiations. And that's what the tenet of democracy is all about. It's democracy. Government of the people by the people. So if you want to start making appointments, the people's interests also matter. But I want to let you know that there are over 5,000 appointments Mr. President will still have to make. So there are still a lot of appointments we are still expecting Mr. President to look into, because right now, about 70% of people that are still working with him are still people that were fixed by the previous government. People that were working with the previous government, they are still the people that are working with this government. And the people on the platform of APC, a lot of people who sacrificed their resources, who risked their life, who believed in Mr. President's change agenda, a lot of people who worked are still feeling that Mr. President should make haste to do some of these appointments so that all the people that deserve to work in his government by now should have been working.
Okay, so and let's look at this list of ambassadors, 47 non-career, 46 career diplomats. Do we need that number of diplomats really for Nigeria at this time, especially in this financial dire straits?
I believe it is what is necessary Mr. President has been doing. I believe in the leadership ability of President Muhammadu Buhari. I have not lost faith in it. The only area where I am losing faith is that area of the kind of politics he has been playing. You cannot say you want to be a democratic president, you want to run a democratic governance, and you don't want to play the politics. So the politics is necessary. And that is why
we understand that. My question is, do we need this number of ambassadors?
That is what I am saying. I believe in his ability to do what is right. I believe
so this
that
is
what
fine.
What he has done is what he feels is right for Nigeria and for his government. If it is not right, he wouldn't have done that. Because this is a grandfather government. you know what it is?
I wonder what you mean by that.
go and give your money to your grandfather to pay for you. You know what I'm talking about.
The national coordinator, change agent Nigeria. Lukayode, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Thank
you.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Let's take a pause now. We'll take a break and then we come back with more. Stay with us.